Hi, and welcome to a screencast on CMake supporting CLion. Now, CMake is central to CLion's operations. So when you make a new project or when you open an existing project, you're going to be working with CMake build scripts. Now, when you import something from sources, you can import a set of files that has nothing to do with CMake per se. And in this case, CLion will simply generate the CMake lists file for you. But here we're going to make a new project. I'll make this one hello CMake, and we'll take a look at how CMake support is actually implemented. So here's our generated project, and you'll notice that all the definitions related to this project are in a file called CMake lists. So that's the project file that CMake will be using to build the application, and CLion itself is using to figure out what's what in the project itself. So as soon as you make any changes, CLion is going to attempt to reload those changes. So for example, let me comment out this line here. As soon as I do that, CLion is telling me that the CMake project needs to be reloaded. And there are two options here. One is to press the link to reload the changes, or I can enable auto reloading, which means that anytime I change the CMake list file, CLion is going to reload the project. Now, CLion, as I mentioned, it takes all the information about the project from this CMake list file, so it figures out what files make up the application, it takes up the target name, it takes variable values, compiler options, and so on. And so operations in CLion quite often involve changes to the CMake list file. So for example, if I were to add a new class, let's call it example, you'll see that there is an option here to add it to the targets. And as soon as I press OK here, if we go back into CMake list, you can see that both the header and the CPP have been added to the CMake list file. Now, of course, in addition to manipulating the CMake list file by adding new classes, for example, you can simply edit it manually. So, for instance, I can add an instruction to find a package, and let's take a look at how this works. So, let's suppose I write find package. Notice I get code completion here. I can simply press return at this point, but I haven't provided a parameter. So what happens is CLion tries to fire up CMake and look for potential problems with the CMake list file, and indeed it reports an error. It tells me that find package is called with an incorrect number of arguments. So if I were to provide a bogus argument like ASDF, for example, then once again CMake does a reload, and now we get a warning that there is no find ASDF.CMake. So let's finally put something sensible in here. And in a similar fashion, CLion provides code completion for the file name. So let me simply comment out the files here. And let's suppose I want to add example to the source file. As soon as I start typing, notice I get code completion for example.cpp and example.h, so I can simply press return here. And since we elected to auto reload the changes, those changes get automatically updated without any involvement from me personally. So we looked at the CMake errors in the appropriate window. Let's take a look at it once again in detail. So I'll bring up CMake. So there are no problems right now, but let's talk about some of the buttons that are available here. So first of all, the CMake settings. Now, before we even jump into CMake, let's talk about the toolchain. And here things are fairly simple because CLion actually bundles a version of CMake, so you don't have to install one unless there is a specific version that you want, in which case you can tick the use specified and simply provide a path for that version. We'll go with the one that's provided for us by CLion, and notice that there is a set of indicators here telling you whether or not the settings you've got are correct. So that's the toolchain in terms of CMake. But let's get back into the CMake settings. So here is our setting for automatically reloading the project on any kind of changes. In addition, it's possible to provide CMake options. So here, for example, I can type dash D and then simply write foo equals bar to provide a property. We're also electing to pass system environment variables, and there is a hyperlink here to show you what those environment variables actually are. And in addition, you can specify additional properties, but once again, typing the name here and some value in here. So in addition to that, you can specify the build option. So for example, specifying how many cores you want your application to be compiled on, and you can also specify the build output path. And this can be either absolute or relative. So for example, I can specify a folder called build that would be relative to my project root. So let's press OK here, and we've incorporated some settings. So now CMake is going to make use of those. And notice we get a small warning here that that setting foo that we specified isn't actually being used for anything. Now, in addition to this setting, there is another setting here called Change Project Root. And to explain how it works, let me give you an example where all of our project files are inside some folder deeper in our project structure. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a new directory, let's call it example. And let's suppose that all of our files are in fact in that directory. So I'll put them in here. Now imagine what would happen if we open the project right now. So let me close CLion, close the project, and we'll open it once again. But this time I'm going to open it from that directory where I put it. So I'm taking the project from the example folder, and as I press hello, well, as you can imagine, I end up having that exact folder as my root. However, what would happen if I wanted to work with the previous folder, the one that I had previously shown? In this case, what I can go into CMake and I can choose an option to change the project root. And now what I can do is I can move up a level, and choosing the higher level folder as the root, I can press OK here. And notice the structure in the project view has changed. We now have the example folder being a subfolder of a higher Hello CMake folder. So in addition to the problems window, we also have the cache window, and this is where you can edit the CMake cache. So once again, you can go into a particular property, you can specify a setting like changing something from on to off, and don't forget to press the save button to incorporate those settings. Finally, let's talk about build targets. So essentially in our CMake list file, we have a single executable called hello CMake. So if you go into the configurations for CLion has inferred from the CMake list file, you will see that there is in fact a hello CMake target here, but there is also a build all target, which incorporates all the targets inside your CMake list file. And these are some of the ways in which CLion supports working with CMake. Now, to find out more about CLion, go to jetbrains.com/CLion. Thanks for watching.